first here, this is not a topic in itself which is original to me. I mean, there have been speakers globally who have talked about trust and specifically building trust online. And I remember reading the book of, I think, Seven Habits of Highly Successful People. And I sort of, you know, I believed in that concept. I know that book exists. And then through some research, I saw that I could pretty much, you know, concisely put everything into seven pillars of trust that you need to succeed online. So while G's, you know, keynote today, a great keynote, by the way, was on pretty much building character, my session would talk about how to build competence with your character. So essentially you need competence and character to succeed, right? You cannot have only competence, you cannot have only character. You need both to succeed. So the first one, design and cleanliness, I mean, that's an example of the restaurant example that I gave you. I'll go in depth, I'll go and give you examples of websites. So now we're going back from the offline to the pure online world. We're purely talking about building trust online. So if you see, the first one is design and cleanliness. The second is extremely interesting, clicky effect. I mean, if all you guys, you're investing your time here, your money here, and if you want to just take one thing, just one thing from this presentation and forget everything else, it should be that click here effect. I'll explain this a bit later, but do note it down. That's the single most important thing. If you had to just, sorry, if I put a gun on your head and said, forget the six pillars, just remember one pillar, then that would be it. Content quality, the edge factor, SEO and social media rankings, all in the name. Again, disclaimer here, it's a Shakespeare thing. I was forced to learn for about 4 years, so it does stay somewhere in the DNA. And technology platform. So these are the seven, after a lot of research and compiling, I said everything that you need to build trust online, on your website or on any online property could be covered in these seven examples. So let's go with design. What a beautiful design is that? How many of you would agree? Would you take out your credit card and pay? You wouldn't. Do you even know what the website does? You don't. You probably can't even read it on that screen. You know, have you seen the credentials? You haven't. Most of you made that decision in like about a millisecond. What about this? Seems good enough. I'd like to learn more. You've got the first impression, now you need more facts. So essentially the whole process of building trust is a combination of one or more of these seven factors. One factor alone cannot build trust. You need one or more factors. One factor would be a leading factor, design. You know, that's always a factor. And again, design is subjective as well. You know, the kind of design an Asian audience would like might be different to an American audience and could be different to a European audience. But still, you know, the basics hold good. How lovely is that? And see this. If you were really hungry, you wouldn't order it from the first website, you would order it from here. So I think I rest my case, you know, design is a very fundamental issue. If you're not good in design, and again, it doesn't mean that you need to have flashy design, but design is a key element of building trust. And again, if you map it to the offline world, you know, you see a person in a suit, in a tie, you probably trust that person slightly more than a person, you know, who's unshaven and has long hair, and, you know, has a bandana or something like that. Click your effect, the favorite one. And this one I would honestly say is something original to my discovery. Now, putting the floor open to you guys, if you had to search, and don't do that by the way right now, if you had to search click here on Google, what would you expect as the first top three result or top two result? Anybody? Google itself, okay, one answer. Second, I'll give you some sort of a prize as well if you answer.
Adobe.
Sorry? Any guesses? Yeah, the most logical answer would be that if you search click here, you'll probably have clickhere.com. But do you know what comes up? Really? Let me show you.
Adobe.
What site comes up?
Adobe.
Adobe. Now, why in the world does Adobe come up when you search for click here? Any clues? I mean, the SEO gurus in this, I would request you not to participate, but sort of the end customers, if you will. Any cases? Why in the world? Yes, please.
Because a lot of cases we have downloading PDFs to a PDF.
Absolutely, absolutely. Almost any website, you know, if it has Flash or if it has a PDF document, it would say, click here to download the PDF reader. Click here to download the Flash plugin. And as you know, Flash is probably on more than 95% or 98% of the websites. PDF is pretty much an open standard today. So you get on every website. So what's really happening? On globally, when Google analyzes the traffic, and this is actually something that a failure of Google. I mean, I don't know if anybody is, I know Google is speaking there, so that's good. But this is actually a fault in Google. When everyone says that click here means, it's like it's the link building in SEO, it's the link building. So if all the links point to Adobe, Google thinks that that must be the most relevant. And hence it puts it up. So what's really happening is, when I say the click here effect, is third party validation. If I tell you I am the greatest guy in town, you'll probably believe me a little. But if you go around and somebody says, and you speak to 10 people, and they say, yeah, you must meet him, he's a great person. Or you, if, for example, you know, if you, if we have many visitors from overseas here, I can see, if somebody says, do you know Sachin Tendulkar? And they say, I don't know. And the moment he starts speaking to more and more people around here, and he listens, he gets the impression he's a big cricketer. He doesn't. So when there's third party validation, your site automatically gets prominence. So link building in a way, but link building is not the only way. So that's what I call the click here effect. Now look at this, and this not only refers to link building. When you get awards, third party validation, certificates, testimonials, anything that shows third parties, not you, you don't brag about yourself, you don't say I'm the best company, I'm the best person, my insurance product is the best. When third people say, when awards, or when absolutely third parties recognize your skill, that's a very high level of trust. And if you see, it's just, you know, there are about a zillion examples online, but we just picked up a few. You see this website, it's trying to sell you something related to networking equipment, it's fine, I don't get any trust. The reason is, I don't get any third party validation. See this site, which is, I'll actually do a case study on this as well, is the Basecamp site, a very popular project management tool. And you have this person from Business Week, a very popular magazine, talking about the site. That builds trust. Look at this site. Again, it's trying to sell something related to tech equipment. Look at this site. Salesforce, brilliant example. You have a person from Dell, and they go even further. Instead of just quoting the person, they actually have a video of someone from Dell talking about their experience with Salesforce. Now, if you just had a testimonial, something written in text with the name, it might be true. But in today's world, that doesn't build your trust to the level that you need to. But when you have the video, it builds the trust.